dividing the landmass, so to speak. You've seen the Navy map, and obviously Gordon Michael Scallion's map, Yadeo's map. There are a lot of very, very intelligent people that have seen different maps, even put out by the intelligence agencies, and then taken down, scrubbed, or denied. But the point is that we're seeing now too many anomalies, especially on the New Madrid. We're seeing kind of a quiet time right now on the West Coast, which means that a lot of concern. I talked to Stan earlier, George, and he was saying, look at what's going on in the South Pacific and the Ring of Fire, and then compare it to the West Coast. South America's had its quakes, but we're due for the quote-unquote bigger ones coming to the West Coast very soon. And then we go into the realm of famine, and famine, the horrific, horrific detriment that the flooding in the Mississippi has done, coupled with the drought in Texas and Arizona. And it's my contention, George, that these fires are being set on purpose, and that it is a, if you will, America is under full-scale attack from the Illuminati.
Well, Stephen, you may be very right there indeed. I want to talk with you about the world, what's going on there, the economy, and also when we come back after the break, October 21st, end times that some people seem to be jumping up and down. What's new with you, Stephen, these days?
Well, my new book, Angel Wars, has done really well. I'm getting that put into electronic format in the next 30 days, and I'm going to have it in for a lot of my visually impaired listeners and yours, too. We're going to have it on an audio format very soon. It's going to be narrated, and actually it's in the studio right now. But I think the thing that's really got me concerned is the economy of the world, and especially what's going on in Europe. As we're talking tonight, George, Europe is really taking a hit. Greenspan has said the euro is about a toast, and obviously we're seeing right now Kotlikoff, Lawrence Kotlikoff, making the statement that the true debt of the United States is $211 trillion. Well, if you take the gross domestic product of the world at $55 trillion, in essence, we're 4 years of every dollar produced, and people are screaming for jobs, and rightly so. But I'd like to remind everybody that even Ross Perot was warning about NAFTA, North American Free Trade Agreement, and GATT, General Agreement on Trades and Tariffs, years ago, and a lot of talk radio warned about it. But the jobs have already been moved overseas, and it's a sad day when, obviously, we have the housing crunch that's going on. We have the compression in savings that's going on, lack of savings, and it is my sadness and my statement that I have to make is it is like an intentional destruction of the middle class. Wall Street has benefited, and they are absolutely the giant vampire squid sucking the life out of the middle class. And now we've got a situation, as you know, where even in the unions now, I mean, it's a sad day when Jimmy Hoffa Jr. says that, you know, it's on the front of Drudge that it's time to, you know, kick the you-know-what out of the bastards, meaning anybody that's a conservative. And I think what's sad is America has become so divided. You know, I love the word American. It doesn't have anything in front of it hyphenated. It doesn't have anything need to be put in parentheses. There is no such thing, or wasn't for a long time. And now when everybody wants to divide it up and make it this type of American, that type of American, and now you've got basically the ethnic, and when I say ethnos, that's nation in New Testament terminology. We've got nation rising against nation. We've got, obviously, the Nation of Islam. We have all these different nations, and we're losing our homogeneity, and God forbid, but I see this, and I remember years ago, you and I speaking on talk radio about the coming civil war, and you said, oh, you pray that's not true, and I said, I hope so, too, but it appears that somebody wants to stir it up.
You got that right. Stephen, hold on for a second. We're going to hit the break, come back, talk about end times on Coast to Coast AM, and phone calls next hour with Stephen Coyle.